Good morning, Vandal. Today we are going to start a discussion on Nyquist-Shannon sampling theorem. You know what we have seen is we have seen some examples, right? Let me consider the notations once again. XCRT is my continuous time signal. What I am doing is I am trying to sample this at every TS interval or T interval. Here TS is nothing but T, sampling period, uniform sampling. Uniform sampling means, for example, this is my XCRT signal. Let me consider this as my continuous time signal XCRT. What I am going to do is, let's say this is T equal to 0, negative, and this is positive time, like that. I'll try to sample this continuous time signal at every t interval where n is integer, n belongs to z. Z means 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on integers, right? Minus 1, minus 2 and so on this side. See z. I'll try to sample this XCRT signal at every t equal to nt. N into capital T, integer multiple of T. This is one of my sample. Let me represent this with according to our notations. This will be x of 0 into delta of T. And this corresponds to x of T into delta of T minus T. And then what will be this third one? What will be the third sample? This one. X of 2t into delta of t minus 2t, like that, and so on. And this side also will proceed. Uniform sampling means the sampling interval is always t. We are going to sample at every t interval. Let me have this as minus t. When n equal to minus 1, this is minus t. X of minus t, right? This will be x of minus t into delta of, yeah, what is this? Yeah, you can respond. X of minus t into delta of, see, delta of t plus t, right? This is delta of t plus t. And x of minus 2t into delta of t plus 2t, and so on. These are my samples. What's my plan is, I want to represent this continuous time signal with the help of discrete samples. That's what my plan, right? And if you want to store that in memory, I will do quantization followed by encoding, converting to binary form, x of n. These are my samples. That's what I am doing. And am I following any criteria here? What is that criteria? Let XCRT is baseband signal band limited to F max. What is the meaning of this? Yeah, one of you can answer. What is the meaning of this? See, you can interact. Yeah, what is the meaning of this one? XCRT is baseband signal, band limited to fmax. See, the meaning of this one is that spectrum of XCRT, it means XC of f, that will be somewhere nearby, baseband means nearby DC components, somewhere nearby this one. And band limited to fmax means highest frequency component in this spectrum is fmax. Let me have some example spectrum as follows. Beyond fmax, there is no frequency component contributing to your XCRT, right? Because all of them are having zero. This is zero, right? After fmax. It means what we are having is this is by symmetry. When x e of t is real, by default you can expect this side symmetric nature. X e of f equal to zero for all mod f greater than f max. Then you can try to say that this x e of t is band limited signal with highest frequency is f max. Like that you can think. This is a notation for that one. Baseband signal band limited to f max. If this is the scenario, what condition you need to follow? What should be your t? Let me call sampling rate fs as 1 by t or 1 by ts. Then what is the relation between fs and f max? What is that criteria? Yeah, what is that criteria? See, yeah, it's better you should use microphone. That's okay for me. You can use microphone to answer the question. Okay, fs greater than 2 f max, right? Okay, that's fine. When we are doing uniform sampling, then we need to maintain this condition in order to get back to my actual signal. Suppose I want to get back to my actual signal xc of t, actual continuous time signal, from this sampled version. What I need to maintain is I need to have fs to be greater than or equal to 2 f max. My sampling rate, where fs equals to 1 by t. 1 by t should be greater than or equal to 2 f max. If I try to follow this sampling rate, I can try to reconstruct my xc of t signal with the help of these discrete samples. How to do this one? How to reconstruct that one? Suppose this is my signal, sampled signal, xc of nt, delta of t minus nt. This is my sampled signal, sampled version. From this, I want to construct my xc of t. And let's assume that I follow this condition. Fs greater than or equal to 2 f max. And let's assume that I have ideal filters with me. But practically that won't exist. But just for namesake, assume that I have ideal filters with me. Then how to reconstruct this signal from this? Yeah, how to reconstruct that? Okay, I can go for low pass filter, right? Low pass filter with a cutoff frequency. I can simply try to apply this signal to a low pass filter, ideal low pass filter, if that exists in our case. Go for this one with a cutoff frequency fc equals to fs by 2. I can go for this, right? Fc equals to fs by 2. Then I can get back to my signal xc of t. From this to this one. And yeah, my question is this. What I am going to ask is, let me consider xc of t, sample this one, and I got xc of nt. These are sequence of samples where n belongs to z. I got sequence of samples. Here, time belongs to real space. T belongs to R. Here, n belongs to z, integer multiples of t. And from this, I started doing quantization followed by encoding. And I got x of n sequence of samples, encoded samples. This I'll try to store in my memory. I stored the sequence of samples in my memory, digital memory. Now, from these samples, I want to get back to my XCRT. How can I get this? See, earlier what I had done is, till now, what I had done is, I tried to convert these sequence of samples. These are the sequence of samples I have. I try to convert this signal into XCRT with the help of ideal low pass filter with a cutoff frequency fs by 2. This is what I had done till now. But actually, I have some digital signal which is stored in my memory. I can't do this process straight away, right? First, I should try to convert this into this format. What I need to do is, first I need to convert x of n into this format. Sigma n equals minus infinity to plus infinity. Xc of n t delta of t minus n t. Once I convert it into this format, then I can apply analog low pass filter with a cutoff frequency fc equals to fs by 2. In order to get back to my XCRT. That thing I can do, right? But how to convert this into this? Any idea? I know how to convert this signal to this signal with the help of analog low pass filter with the cutoff frequency fs by 2. If I am able to convert this signal to this signal, then I can get back to this one with the help of low pass filter. But how to convert this to this? These are the samples, encoded samples, stored in memory, digital memory. Yes. Yeah, any idea about this? Okay, decode. Someone answered me decode. Yeah. Up to that, that's fine. Suppose I decoded the samples. After decoding, with the help of a decoder, I have binary data in my memory. I decoded them and I got the samples as follows. Let me construct the samples I am going to get are as follows. After decoding, and according to our earlier knowledge, we should pass this through analog low pass filter with a cutoff frequency fs by 2. But in what order? Do I need to maintain, how much gap should be maintained between sample to sample? See, after decoding, I am going to get the set of samples as follows after decoding. But with the help of decoding, I can't align this with the required gap, right? What should be this time gap? How much gap I need to maintain? You can have a look into this. How much gap I am maintaining between sample to sample? What is the time gap between sample to sample? Yeah, if you want, you can type, that's also fine for me. T, right? Capital T. I need to maintain this sample gap also, right? Just decoding is not enough. While transmitting those samples through analog low pass filter or analog reconstruction filter, I need to maintain this gap also. I will decode first sample and after that I'll maintain a gap of T, where T equals to 1 by fs. And I will decode this. After decoding this one, I will maintain a gap of t. And I will decode this. Like this, I need to transmit, right? I need to maintain this also. This should be same as my 1 by fs. This should not mismatch with this one, right? That should match to this one. Otherwise, I will be in trouble. I should try to maintain the same thing. It means I should try to store what is my sampling rate also somewhere in the memory. along with encoded samples, I need to store what is my sampling date or what is my sampling period T somewhere in the memory. Because without this information, I don't know how much gap I need to maintain while transmitting through analog reconstruction filter. I should know this also, right? This gap also. If I don't know this, I might do something like this. Then I will be in trouble, right? I might do it with less time, or I might do it with more time. That's the issue I'm going to get. This also should be maintained. Yeah. If you are able to do all these things, then you can try to reconstruct your actual signal XERT from the sampled version. It's possible, right? Even that's stored in the memory. But in this case, even though you are having ideal filters with you, hypothetically assume that you have ideal low pass filter, there is some problem. What is that problem? Can you comment? Do you think we are going to get actual signal or some corrupted signal in the reverse process? Do you think I am going to get actual signal or some approximation to this? Which one you may get? XC hat means some approximation to XC of T. Let's assume that you have ideal filters with you. Yeah. Someone answered like due to quantization noise, and which is irreversible process, that noise you can't avoid, right? Some approximation we are going to get. Some approximation we are going to get, even though if you assume that you have ideal filters with you, we'll get approximation due to quantization noise, which is an irreversible process. Some approximation we are going to get. But that's fine, it's tolerable. I can use some example for that one. For example, yeah, now I'm trying to speak with you, right? Yeah, now I'm trying to speak with you. What's happening is that microphone is trying to get the signal. It's trying to get the signal. After that, just doing sampling followed by quantization. That means some quantization error is there, which we can't avoid. And that encoded signal you are getting at your receiver end, that's doing decoding followed by analog reconstruction, such thing that's happening, right? But you are able to get my information. Even though there is some quantization noise, that's tolerable up to some level, right? Whatever the information I am going to convey to you, that speech information, you are able to get irrespective of that quantization noise effects. It means you can think like up to some quantization error, you can tolerate. You can get the information properly. Up to that, you can guarantee. If the number of bits or number of quantization levels I am using are very, very less, then your quantization error will be very high. In such scenario, you may not tolerate that noise. That voice you are going to get from me, that might look very, very bad. If your quantization error is so high, it depends on the number of quantization levels we are going to use. In general, for speech, we are going to go for 8-bit quantizer. 8-bit quantization means, it's a basic standard. How many quantization levels will be there? 8-bit quantization means? Yeah, how many? 8-bit quantization. 2 power 8, right? 2 power 8 means how much? 256 quantization levels, right? 256 quantization levels. It depends on the how many levels you are using. Yeah, that's fine. Let's feel that quantization error is tolerable in our application. Then there's no issue with this one, right? I am able to get almost same XCRT if I do this process. But during this entire process, I am trying to follow this constraint, right? My sampling rate should be greater than or equal to f max, where f max is the maximum frequency of my message signal. The baseband signal band limited to f max. If I am able to satisfy this constraint, I can try to reconstruct my signal XCRT, actual signal XCRT, from the sampled version effectively with the help of analog low pass filter with the cutoff frequency fs/2. Yeah, that corresponds to Nyquist Shannon sampling theorem altogether. And let me have some notations. You can try to remember these notations, whatever I'm going to say. Highest, according to that one, yeah, what is the highest message signal frequency allowed? If I gave you sampling rate fs, then what is the highest possible message frequency we can allow?
fs/2.
fs/2, right? Because we need to maintain fs to be greater than or equal to f max. Then f max should be less than or equal to fs/2, right? I need to maintain this one. F max should be less than or equal to fs/2. I need to maintain this condition, right? And this frequency is named as fn. You can try to remember this notation, fn equals to fs/2. And this is called as Nyquist frequency. It's a person name. Nyquist frequency. It's a Nyquist frequency. Fn equals to fs/2. And according to your guess, what can be Nyquist rate? Nyquist rate is nothing but 2 times f max. Minimum required sampling rate, if you are having ideal filters with you, minimum required sampling rate in order to reconstruct your analog signal properly in that sampled version. This is Nyquist rate. You can just try to remember this terminology. Nyquist frequency means fs/2. Nyquist rate means 2 times f max. It's a Nyquist rate. And if I try to convert that into radians per second, you can go with these notations, omega n, omega s/2, where omega s equals to 2 pi fs, omega n equals to 2 pi fn. It's just notation. I can go for capital omega max if I multiply with 2 pi. There is just some switch over, that's it. You can have a look into this later. Yeah, it's Nyquist-Shannon sampling theorem. This is what we have discussed till now. Okay, what will be impulse response for the ideal low pass filter? What we have is, we are passing XC of NT samples, that entire structure is there, right, for every T interval. We are passing that through analog low pass filter with a cutoff frequency of fs/2, right? Say 0. This is plus fs/2. This is ideal low pass filter. This is minus fs/2. And gain is t. Instead of gain 1 in the pass band, gain t. Because that 1 by t gets cancelled out, right? As we have seen in the last class. This is our setup. What is the inverse Fourier transform for this one? What is the inverse transform for this?
Sync.
Sync function, right? We are going to get some sort of sync function. Sync function means we are going to get up to infinite duration, right? But this ripple strength will keep on decreasing. We are going to get this kind of impulse response. So what we call as impulse response of this ideal filter. That's why this is practically impossible to design this filter. It's a non-causal system. We can't make it like a causal system where this is indefinitely going, right? HFT is not equal to 0 for t less than 0. We can't implement this practically. Let's assume, at least theoretically, something is there like that you can imagine. Yeah, what should be this one? I think this is 1 by t, right? If t is the sampling period, this will be minus 1 by t. This will be 2 by t, minus 2 by t, and so on. Is it like that? There is some mistake, right? This time domain. This is 1 by 2t. Fs equals 1 by t, right? This is 1 by 2t. This is minus 1 by 2t. Fs equals 1 by t, I am replacing. Then what should be this one? This duration corresponds to 1 by 2t minus or minus 1 by 2t. Or fs, right? Fs means 1 by t. This gap, this whole thing. Rectangle width is 1 by t. And this should be t, right? T minus t, something like this, we are going to get. Let's have the precise one. It's a precise one. It's an impulse response of that ideal reconstruction filter. If you pass the sampled sequence through this filter with this impulse response of that LTI system, then we are going to end up with the actual signal XCRT. That's what our plan. You can have a look into this one. The ideal low pass filter, the cutoff frequency fs by 2 and minus fs by 2. Here omega, right? Omega means 2 pi into fs by 2. Here 2 pi into minus fs by 2, where fs equals to 1 by t. Then we are going to get this one. And these figures are from discrete time signal passing by Oppenheim. By default, what are the figures we are going to keep? They are mostly belongs to discrete time signal passing by Oppenheim. And this will go indefinitely, both sides. Now, yeah, what will happen in the time domain? Frequency domain, that is multiplication. In time domain, what's happening here? If this is my sampled version, n equal to minus infinity plus infinity, xc of nt, delta of t minus nt, this is my sampled version. And if I try to pass this through an LTA system with an impulse response, let me go to the same notation, hr of t, reconstruction filter, analog reconstruction filter. Then what should be my outcome when this LTA system, this impulse response? It's a time domain. If my input is x of t and impulse response is h of t, then what should be my output when that is LTI system? See my impulse response, LTI. And what should
convolution
be
of x of t and h of t, sir?
Yes. It's a linear convolution of x of t and h of t, right? I can do the same thing here. It's a linear convolution of this and this. And what is delta of t minus nt convolution with h of t? So, dear, right? You might heard about x of t convolution with delta of t minus tau. That is same as x of t minus tau, right? This is h of t minus nt. Here we are going to get sigma n equal to minus infinity plus infinity, x of nt, and this convolution will be hr of t minus nt. Like that we are going to get. You can have a look into this. Yeah, drawing is a bit difficult here. I'll try to have this slide itself. These are my samples. Let's assume that this is 0. This is t equal to 0. This corresponds to x of 0 delta of t. This corresponds to x of 1 delta of t minus t. X of 2 delta of t minus 2. X of 3 delta of t minus 3. Then what should be this one? This is 0, this is minus 1. Then what should be this?
of minus 1
X
del
of
of
t. No,
minus
no.
1.
X of minus t. This gap is t, right? Okay, x of minus t delta of t plus t. And this will be x of minus 2t. This time will be minus 2t. X of minus 2t delta of t plus 2t. 2 into capital T. First one is small t and the second one is capital T. Yeah. This is my sampled version. After doing convolution, what I am going to get is, as we have seen this, right? Just now, we are going to get something like this. For n equal to 0, x e of 0 into h r of t. For n equal to 1, plus, right? Summation means plus. Plus x e of t into h r of t minus t. Plus, for n equal to minus 1, x e of minus t into h r of t plus t. Like that we are going to get, right? That's what happening here. You can have a look into this. Let me consider this 0 index, t equal to 0. This corresponds to, this sync pulse corresponds to, this sync pulse corresponds to x e of 0 into delta of, no, x e of 0 into h r of t. And this sync pulse corresponds to, this sync pulse is there, right? This corresponds to, yeah, what is this impulse? This corresponds to x e of t into x e of capital T into h r of t minus t. Can someone answer what is this impulse? Yeah, I can try. What is this impulse? This corresponds to xr of 2t. Oh, this xc of 2t. Xc of 2t into hr of t minus 2t. Then what should be this one? Yeah, you can respond, right? Yeah. What is this impulse? What is that sync pulse?
X e of 3t.
Okay, x e of 3t into hr of t minus 3t, right? Shifted version of that sync. Now everything gets added. That summation operation, right? All are getting added. Once, you can try to have a look into this one. Here, how many of them are getting added at this point? You can try to see this value is getting added with this value, and this also getting added, this also getting added, this also getting added. It means it's trying to add all the contributions from the neighboring samples in order to generate missing values in between. See, these are the missing values in between, right? We just have this sampled version. We don't know what is there in between. We are trying to reconstruct these missing values with the help of the existing samples. Just by doing some sort of interpolation, it's called as interpolation, the linear convolution with HR of T. That's what we are doing here. After interpolation, we are able to get back to my actual signal X of T, right? You can try to add the Y coordinate values, all these values. Then we are going to end up with this curve. If we add all these impulses, that's what we are going to get finally. It's called as interpolation. If you want, you can cross check at the sample point. Let me have this t equal to 0 point. How many are getting added? We're having only one sync, right? You can have a look into this one. Only this one is non-zero. Everyone is becoming zero at this point, right? Except this sample. Similarly, at this point, you can try to have look into this one. Only this sync pulse is contributing non-zero value. Everyone is becoming zero, right? At this point, all others are becoming zero. When you look into construction of this intermediate one, then there is some contribution from multiple samples. This is contributing something, and this is contributing something to this one. This sample is contributing something to this one. Some weighted combination. Some weightage is given from the sample also. You can see. This is non-zero, this is also non-zero. This is non-zero, this is non-zero, this is non-zero, this is non-zero, right? It's a weighted combination from neighboring samples. If you go far away, the weightage given to this sample is also less from that sample. The reason is, this keeps on decreasing, right? This ripple keeps on decreasing as you go far away. That means neighboring samples will try to contribute more in order to guess the missing sample. The neighboring samples will contribute more. The faraway samples will try to contribute less. They will have less weightage. Something like weighted combination of all those samples in order to reconstruct my actual analog signal. This is an intuitive, the intuition behind that one. And you can have a look into this figure. This is my signal X of N stored in my digital memory after encoding. After that, what I am doing is, in order to convert to analog signal once again, I am trying to send those samples with a gap of T, where T equals to 1 by FS, through ideal reconstruction filter, analog filter, with a cutoff frequency FS by 2. Then I am going to get back to my XE of T signal, approximately XE of T. Due to quantization, I am not getting exact one. And that too, in practical scenario, you won't have ideal reconstruction filter. You are going to have some transition band for your filter, and that will also affect you a little bit. That's why you are going to get approximation to XE of T. You won't get exact XE of T. And make sure that you are sending those samples with a gap of T through that filter. And this is a big picture of that whole thing. XERT, analog to digital conversion, followed by some discrete time processing. If you want to process it, you can process that one. See, till now, the application we have considered is, we are just sampling and storing somewhere in the memory. And we are trying to reconstruct my actual signal as it is. Instead of that, we can do some processing also, right? For example, I have showed something in the starting lectures, right? For example, while recording, that song is getting affected by noise. Noise also recorded along with the song. Now I can try to apply some digital filtering operation. I'll try to remove that noise part up to some level, out of band noise at least. After that, I'll try to construct back my actual signal. Some processing also I can do in between. It means my expected waveform at the output, final output, need not be same as XERT. That can be processed version of this one. You may not expect exact XERT all the time. It depends on application. Sometimes I may need to process that digitally. After that, I need to convert to analog. You may not expect exact XERT at this. You may need to do some processing also. That's based on application. Okay, it's fine. Let me stop recording. Okay, do we